Hello everyone. Today we'll be seeing a new chapter which is called as Matra Chaturthaya. This is the 8th chapter in Ashtanga Hridaya. This has been mentioned after explaining about Anyaraksha Vidyadhyaya, in which Acharya has told about how to protect from different toxic materials or contamination of food. And he has also explained how various foods can cause various diseases in the body, like Viruddhahar, etc. So even after explaining about all those concepts, there are still some more quantity or quality of food that can lead to manifestation of some diseases in the human being. So to explain that in detail, he has mentioned or he has explained a chapter called Matra Ashitiyam Adhyaya. Here Matra means the quantity, Ashitiyam means to consume. So how much quantity of food that a person should consume is being mainly explained in this chapter. So he understood that it is not just the quality of food that can cause visheshan of doshas and can cause different body problems. Even the quantity of food is also very much important in manifestation of diseases. So to explain that in detail, this chapter is mentioned as the 8th chapter of Ashtanga Hridaya Sutrasthana. So this is a very, very important chapter. There are lots of important concepts have been explained in this. So I will be starting this chapter till Dandalasaka I will be explaining over here in this video. Followed by that, later things will be sent to you very shortly in other videos. So let's start this chapter. So the chapter begins with a very beautiful quotation, saying about the importance of matra, or how we have to consider the quantity that a person should consume as a standard dosage. So he says that matra shi sarvakalam syat matra hi agnir pravartikaha matra dravyani apekshante guruni api laghuni api guru nam ardha sauhityam laghu nam nadi triptaha मात्रा प्रमाणम निर्दिष्टः सुखम यावत् विचीरितिः. So this four lines slogan explain what is the ideal quantity of food that a person should consume in his daily routine. So he says that matra sarvakala, all the times, whatever be the time period, whether it is based on ritu or ushna kala or grishma or varsha kala, whatever it is, or whether it is depending upon the age of the patient. So in all these places, the matra or the quantity a person should take depends upon the agni of the patient. It should be agni pravartaka, or it should be in that form which does not hamper the agni or does not cause any problem to the agni, or further it improves the agni of the patient. So that is considered as a matra of the particular individual. For me, the matra will be different. For you, the matra may be different. So it depends upon how good our agni is. So the quantity is something that can be used as a something that improves our agni rather than destroying that. So it is just like adding fuel to our agni. So if you are taking any normal quantity of food, that will help in adding more power to the agni. Just like, even though you know that the ghee is something that improves the fire, or it can ignite the fire in a very good form, but just imagine you have a big of fire, a very small fire is there, and you pour a whole bottle of ghee over that. So even though the ghee was supposed to flare up the fire, this quantity of ghee is so much that it will destroy the fire, right? So in the same way, our agni is also just like a fire. So if you slowly add fuel to it, it will flare up, it will ignite, it will work very properly. Rather than that, if you totally pour something that can just extinguish, then that quantity is not considered to be ideal for the patient. Okay. Now again he says that matra dravyan apekshante. So this quantity will depend upon the dravyas. Dravyas means whatever food items what you are taking. Okay, apekshante means it depends. And this dravya can be broadly classified into guruni api laghuni api cha. So there are two kinds of dravyas, what we can say. Some are guru dravya, some are laghu dravyas. guru dravyas are that which are very easy to which are very hard to digest, which are very heavy to digest, or which improves the bulkiness of the body. And laghu are those substances which are very light to digest, or which causes lightness in the body. For example, you can see that goduma or wheat is a guru ahara compared to rice. Rice is a laghu ahara. So if you take rice, just only rice, it will get digested very quickly and you may feel hunger even before the next meal time. But if you are taking gehu or if you are taking wheat, that will take long time to digest and you will not feel hungry very quickly. So this is how the matra should be considered. If you are taking guru ahara or laghu ahara, based on that you should consider your matra. Now how much matra you have to take? Guru nam ardha sauhityam. If you are taking guru ahara, then take it to ardha sauhitya, half of your satiety or half of your, what is the satisfaction? You are feeling hungry and you are going to take guru ahara, don't take full stomach, just take half of your satisfaction. For example, if you are getting satisfied, if you are able to suppress your hunger after taking two chapatis, then stop it over there. Don't take the third one. Whereas in laghu ahara, na adi traptaptiha. If you are taking laghu ahara, it should not be taken in an oversatiated form or oversatisfactory form. For example, if you are satisfied with three dosas, then that is the quantity you have to take. Don't take more than that. So I hope you understood this line. If you are taking guru ahara, it should be taking half of your satisfaction. If you are taking laghu ahara, it should not be over satisfying you. It should be taken to the level of your satisfaction. Okay? Matra pramana nirdishta sukham yavat vi jiryatehi. So, matra pramana or the quantity of the food is being understood as something that will undergo jiryataha sukham, or which will be able to get digested without causing any trouble to the patient, which can get digested with sukha or easy digestible form. That is considered as the ideal matra for the patient. Okay, so you yourself have to analyze what is the ideal quantity for your food. It should be depending upon your agni. Your agni should be flared up after taking the food. It should not get extinguished. It depends upon the dravya, and dravya can be broadly classified into two forms, guru and laghu. And if you're taking guru ahara as a food, then you should be taken only to the half of your satisfaction. If you are taking laghu ahara for your food, it should be taken not in an excessive form. And again, you should also consider that the matra or the quantity of the food is something that get digested very easily without causing any problem to the person. So this is about the quantity of food, how much or what your person should be taken. Now let's go further and see what else is being told over here. Now he is telling about the doshas or the problem that can be caused by hina ati matra. If you are taking very less amount of food or if you are taking excessive amount of food, what it can cause to us, that has been explained in this sloka. But he says that bhojanam hina matram to na bala upachaya ojasaha. So if you are taking hina matra ahara, if you are taking very less quantity of food, means you are going into too much of dieting and all those things, to that na bala upachaya ojasa, that will never going to cause bala or ojas or upachaya. Bala means that is never going to improve your bala, or that is not going to provide you strength. Upachaya means that is not going to do the general nourishment of the body, and that is not going to create any ojas in you, or any, what you say, ojas. I hope you know what the end of all the, it's the essence of all the seven dhatus, that indicate that the formation of all the seven dhatus will not happen properly. Okay, so if you are taking food in a very less quantity, it is going to neither provide you strength nor provide you nourishment, nor your dhatus are going to be manifested properly. And along with that, sarvesham vada roganam hetutaha prapadyate. Understand that this is going to be the causative factor for all the vataja vikaras. The person can get multiple disorders because of aggravation of vata. That means less quantity of food can aggravate vata in a person. Okay, now this is a problem if you take less quantity of food. That means hina matra or alpa matra ahara can cause all this problem. It it doesn't produce bala, it doesn't does the upachaya or nourishment, it doesn't create ojas properly, and can lead to may have all vadacha vikaras. Now coming to the next point, that is atimatra. Atimatra is excessive quantity of food. So this is hinamatra and this is atimatra. Atimatram punaha sarvan ashu doshan prakopyate. The atimatra ahara, if you take excessive quantity of food, that is going to sarvan ashuhu. All the doshas get prakupta immediately. Ashu means immediately or quickly. So if you take excessive quantity of food than what was required by the person, it is going to vitiate all the doshas and cause diseases pertaining to all the doshas. Okay. Now in comparisons of hina matra and atimatra, atimatra is more severe in nature. Hina matra we can manage it with various modalities, but atimatra ahara can cause multiple disorders and this is very serious in nature. Okay, so it is better to have less quantity of food, if at all it's always better to have the ideal quantity of food. But if at all there is a condition that you want to choose whether you have to go for dieting or you have to go for overnourishment, then better to go for dieting, because that can cause less, even though it's not good to do too much of dieting also. But this excessive quantity of food can cause multiple disorders and which is very hard to treat. So let's never try to attempt this. Okay, now let's see what are other diseases, other problems that is caused by the atimatra ahara. Now this sloka explains about the problems create out of excessive consumption of food. Pidya mano hi vata deha yugapat tena kopatehe. So this atimatra ahara is going to vitiate vata deha. Vata deha means vata and other dosha. Okay, pidya mano, it is going to trouble these all dosha. And yugapatena kopatehe, immediately these are going to get aggravated, or there is an immediate flaring up of all the three doshas, not only vata dosha. Adhya means etc. So vata etc. doshas, that means vata, pitta and kapha, all the doshas are going to flare up immediately. Okay, amena annena dushtena tadevat avashiyam kurvate. So this thing is going to be formed in the manner of something called as ama. Ama means undigested food or food which is not properly digested. So ama, amena anena dushtena. So this ama, that means the food which is not properly digested in your stomach, along with the anna, along with the next food what you're taking, that means the previous food which was not properly digested or which was not properly converted into dhatus, along with the newly taken food, dushtena tadeva avashya kurvate, this will get vitiated and will reside in the intestine. Vishtamba yanto alasakam cha avyanto visuchikam, this will lead to a condition called as alasaka. Alasaka, you can see it over here. Alasaka is a disease by blocking the movement of food inside the alimentary tract. Okay, so vishtamba yanto, it causes tampana, it causes blockage of food. Vishtamba means there is a obstruction of the food, and this condition is called as alasaka. Okay, so the food which is mixed with the previous undigested food gets vitiated and reside in the intestine without moving outside is called as alasaka. This is the first disease that is being caused, which is a very important disease, and it can also lead to next disease called as visuchika, where is adottara marga pyaha sahaso sahaser va jitatmanaha. So there is another condition called as visuchika, where this vitiated anna and ama comes out in the adha and uttara marga. Adha and uttara marga means, adha marga means through the lower orifices and uttara marga is through the upper orifices. That means either in the form of dysentery or loose motion, or in the form of omitting this toxic material which is ama and anna mixed together will come out, which is called as the next disease called as visuchika. Okay, so here we have two diseases, one is alasaka and other is visuchika. The first one is a disease where the anna is getting mixed with previously consumed undigested food which is called as ama, and reside in the intestine in a intoxicated manner or in a dushta avastha, which is called as alasaka. and in the next condition it is coming out through the upper and the lower orifices, which is called as visuchika. Okay, and this is seen in sahseva jitatmanah. This is always seen in, normally it is seen in a person who is not having control over his habits, or who is not having control over his senses. That means a person who can't control his overeating. In such persons, or in such persons, this disease of alasaka and visuchika is being formed. Okay, now let's go in deep about what is alasaka and what is visuchika. Alasaka, what you can say is that prayatihi na urdhva na adha aharo na cha pachate amashe alasi bhutaste na so alasakam smritaha. It's a very important sloka. Just try to by heart it very properly. Prayatihi na urdhva, as we said, it doesn't comes out through the urdhva marga, nor from the upper orifices, na adha, nor from the lower orifices. Aharo na cha pachate, the food which is not even getting digested. That means you have consumed the food, that food item is not coming out from your upper orifices, not going down through your lower orifices, and not getting digested also. So this is a very awkward situation. You are just stuck up. Okay, the food is not getting digested. If it is getting digested, it will be converted into the dhatus and getting cleared up, but this is not getting digested. It is not coming in the form of vomits. It is not coming as a vomit, or you are not able to expel it out, nor going down in the form of fecus. So it is just amashe alasi bhudan. It resides in the amashaya, in alasya means laziness, in just like a lazy thing which resides in the amashaya. So alasakam smritaha, that entity is called as alasaka. Means here the food is not getting expelled in any of the routes, not getting digested, reside in the stomach, causing various troubles, is called as alasaka. Okay, now let's see what are the things related to that. In later thing we'll see visuchika's definition first, then we'll see the symptoms of alasaka. Now first one is visuchika and second one is, so first one is alasaka and second one is visuchika. Now the visuchika is totally something different from that. Vibhidheer vedane bhedeer khaadi prashakopataha suchibir iva gatrani vidyati visuchika. So visuchika is a condition where you have vivida vedana, different kinds of pains will be there, and of course there will be khaadi prashakopati. Khaadi means vata, kha means is a synonym of vata, khaadi means vata, etc. Doshas will get kopataha, it will get aggravated. Okay, so there will be different type of pain, and there will be visheshan of tridoshas. Suchibhir iva gatrani vidyatiti visuchikaha. So you will have some kind of pain which is similar to that of pricking with a suchibhir iva. Means you will feel that as if something is pricking in your stomach with a needle. Suchi means needle. So that kind of pain is there, and that condition is called as visuchika. So here what happens is that you have severe pain. In alasaka the pain was not been mentioned. Here you have severe pain, and along with that there are different other kinds of pain can be experienced, and there will be vishesha of all the doshas. Okay, so here we have seen in the previous sloka that in visuchika there is expulsion of material from both urdhva and adho bhaga. Means the food item which is being vitiated with ama can get expelled either from upper or from lower orifice. Along with that there will be severe pain, prakopa of all the tridoshas, and pain as if pricked by needles. This condition is called as visuchika. Okay, here also food is not getting digested and converted into dhatus, rather it is getting expelled from the upper or the lower orifice. Okay, now coming to the symptoms of different doshas, how it causes different as I told that there are khadir vishakopataha, different doshas are getting increased in alasaka and visuchika. How these different doshas are going to cause different conditions or different symptoms in alasaka and visuchika has been explained in this slide. So they say that if vata is getting aggravated in alasaka and visuchika, it can cause these symptoms along with it. Symptoms like shula. Shula, the meaning of shula is that it can cause abdominal pain. Brahma, Brahma means it can cause delusion. Along with the previous symptoms of alasaka and visuchika, it can cause these symptoms. This is the additional symptoms. Okay, if vata is vitiated more, It can cause anaha. Anaha means bloating or fullness or distension of abdomen. Kamba, kamba means tremors, and stamba, stamba means stiffness or no movements at all. These will be the symptoms when vata is aggravated. And when pitta is aggravated, it can cause jara, fever. It can cause atisara, diarrhea, especially in visujika. Antardaha, burning sensation from the internal part of the body. Like you'll be having, like you'll be feeling that you are burning from inside. Threat means excessive thirst. Pralaya, pralaya means a condition of similar to that of death but not death. Like you will be having a panicking condition with unconsciousness, or you will lose your senses. That is condition is called as pralaya. And when kapha is aggravated, it can cause chardi, it can cause severe vomiting. In pitta you see adhisara, in kapha you will see chardi, because kapha in the urdha part, urdha bhaga means it is an upward part of the body, so it can cause vomit in the patient. Then anga guruta, heaviness in the body. Vak sangha, difficulties to speak or sluggard speech can be seen. Stivana, excessive salivation or excessive spitting nature or excessive filling of fluids in your buccal cavity can be seen if kapha is aggravated in visujika and alasaka. Okay, so this is symptoms as per the doshas. Along with the main symptoms of alasaka and visujika, these symptoms can also be included if particular doshas are increased. Now, exclusive symptoms of alasaka is that we said that alasaka is a state where the food is not getting expelled from upper and lower orifices, or nor it is getting digested. It's just reside in the amashya with no movements and causing trouble to the patient. What kind of troubles we can have is that visheshat durbalasya alpavanyer vega vega vidharanihi pididam marutena. So especially this is found in those people who are durbalasya, who are very weak, alpavanye, whose digestive condition is very poor, who are having a habit of vega vidharana, who are having a habit of suppressing the natural urges. In these people, pididam marutena annam. So these people, doshas like maruta will get aggravated, which will affect the anna. Anna means the food, whatever you will take. Later, sleshma will get aggravated. Later, in the last, rudhiram andaram. At the end, rudhira. Rudhira means rakta will also get aggravated or get vitiated. Alasam shobhati doshaha. So this will cause increase in the doshas, and shobha shobhidam annaha. This will cause vishesham of the anna also. The anna what you consumed is getting vitiated. Along with that, doshas like maruta, sleshma and rudra is also vitiated. And this shobhita anna or this vitiated anna or ahara, shalyatvena eva samsthitam, it will be residing in the intestine in the form of a shalya. Shalya means a foreign material. So usually ahara should be something that should have been get digested and absorbed by the human. But this, because of the vishesha of this anna or vishesha of this ahara, it will reside in the amashya in the form of a shalya. It will reside as a foreign material in the person. And shuladi kurude tivra chardi atisara varjitan, it will cause severe kind of pain and all the other symptoms explained above in tivra avastha, in a very severe avastha. But here chardi atisara varjitan, along with that chardi and atisara symptoms will not be seen in this stage. This is called as alasaka. Means all these symptoms can be seen in alasaka, but just exclude chardi, sorry, chardi and atisara. These two symptoms will not be seen. Other than that, all the symptoms can be seen in alasaka. Okay, but these will be seen in tivra form. Tivra form means the intensity will be just much ahead of what is being seen in the visujika. Okay, so this disease is called as alasaka. I hope you got it. And there is one more condition of alasaka. This is just the complication of alasaka. Alasaka means it is the starting form of the disease. And when it's resident for a long period of time or highly vitiated, this is called as danda alasaka. We see what it is. Atyartha dushtastu doshaha dushta bhi baddhakha yandi tiriya tanu sarvam dandam stambhayanti cheti dandalasakam namam tam tyajet ashukarinam. So this is a condition when In the Alasaka, we have seen that Dushtana or the Visheshana dosha is happening, but Atyartha Dushtastu dosha, excessive Visheshana dosha can cause Dushta bhi baddha bhav. It can cause Dushta of all the channels, especially the GI tract and all, which lead to the Yandi Tiryak Tanu Sarvam, which lead to the Tiryak Gati of these things. Means, usually we have Anuloma Gati, the foot material should pass in the downward track. But because of the obstruction of the channels of GI tract, this thing will try to move in the opposite direction. Means Tiryak Gati. Tiryak means just return or U-turn. And what it causes, neither it can, in the upper portion also it is blocked, in the lower portion of it is blocked. Dandava stamba in the chedi, it will make the body rigid like a danda. Danda means like a stick. It will make you, make your body rigid. This condition is called as danda alasaka. Here, condition of alasaka, where the foot material is obstructed in the GI tract and which is trying to turn in the opposite direction and make the entire body stiff like a log or like a piece of wood, is called as danda alaka. Tejet ashukaranam. You should always try to avoid these things because it is ashukarana. It can cause immediate death in the patient. So this is the condition called as danda alasaka. I think you understood these concepts. It's a very, very important concept because based on these, the entire other protocol of treatment is depending. So please go through these slides once again. And in case of any doubts, we can have that in our discussion classes. With this, I conclude my today's talk. Thank you very much. Thank you.